That's my dog. But I do know this is our last time together as a class. Nobody in front of me is the same person that they were when they walked in these doors for the first time. And nobody in front of me will be the same person after we leave for the last time. Why tonight is an extremely exciting and anticipated time, it is also very sad. You will say goodbye to your friends, goodbye to your family. Over the last 4 years, we have been guided and molded into better classmates, better friends, and most importantly, better people altogether. Everything we have been taught has prepared us for the journey we are about to embark on. I have learned countless lessons from the class of 2018 that will stick with me forever. But if there is one thing that I hope all of you have learned, it is this. Go out into the world and achieve all that you can. Do great for the people around you, and never, no matter what, forget where you came from. As you leave this gym tonight, look around. Remember the way you feel right now. Remember the people that surround you. Go home and enjoy your family. Enjoy your friends, because nothing will ever be the same as it is in this moment. Congratulations, class of 2018. Good evening, Director of Schools, Mr. Haney, members of the Trenton School District Board of Trustees, Principal Hooker, faculty, staff, family, friends, and fellow graduates. Since I walked through the doors of Trenton Rosemont Middle School, I have felt welcomed and loved by my class. I could never have imagined being in this moment at this time. If someone asked 12-year-old Justin Love about her high school career, she would have just shrugged her shoulders and went on about her day. Young troopers don't think about the future, let alone questions. The reality of high school was not a reality at all. As middle schoolers, the only things in our mind were who we were going to sit by at lunch and how to skip being the table watcher that day. In the sixth grade, we were so blind to the outside world, the only aspects of life that mattered was our sixth grade drama. In seventh grade, we were ludicrous. So ludicrous that Savion Mayberry drank chocolate milk off the floor because he still told us. Once again, we had no care in the world and high school wasn't even on our mind. In eighth grade, we matured only a little bit to understand whose boyfriend was who and who were our true friends and who were not. That year, I felt like the class learned a lot from each other. We were unified, strong-minded, and still crazy as ever. High school was approaching, but we did not realize how fast. As we walked across the gym floor of the middle school, we were finally high schoolers with big things to come. The 4 years I have spent at Peabody have defined me for the rest of my life, as they have defined you for the rest of your lives. You just don't know it yet. Freshman year, we were all just babies, thinking our classes were hard. Peabody High School was amazing compared to the middle school. There were new teachers, new students, and new ventures awaiting us. We walked down the hallways in pairs, terrified that the upperclassmen were going to look our way. Sophomore year, we were untamed and officially ready for the Peabody halls, or so we thought. The upperclassmen didn't scare us anymore, and our classes were a breeze. The drama and rumors of sophomore year were unreal. We were so immature, and life was a game for us, our playground even. We were wise fools to think we had our lives figured out. Junior year, life really hit us. Between Ms. Burchetta and the ACT, we were in for a reality check. Senior Hoyt didn't take it easy on us either. Time management really had to come into play, or we were in for a kick in our butt by this thing called life. On the brighter side, we finally had chances. Chances to get real playing time in the sports we love, chances to get jobs, chances to clear the colleges we wanted to attend, and chances to branch out. Now, here we are. Senior year. This year, I personally become friends with people I wish I would have been friends with throughout my entire high school career. Just like in eighth grade, we have become even more united, strong-minded, and a whole lot more crazy. All year, if you ask any senior in the class of 2018 how he or she was feeling, most likely the reply was, I'm just trying to graduate. Now, here we are, graduating. As you see here, a little reflection seems in order. Reflect on our 4 years together. Reflect on our freshman decision versus our senior decision. Reflect on the conversation we have had amongst ourselves. These are our last high school reflections. This is going to be our last time together as a class. It will be the last time we hear Coach Hooker yell about Walmart sales, the last time we look at David Jacobs as he's walking down the hallway, the last time we fall asleep in Coach Patrick's class, the last time for everything. As we reflect upon our life lessons learned, we see these lessons prepare us for prosperity to come. We have been told by numerous authority figures that our class is the best of the best. Academically acclaimed, athletically skilled, musically talented, and extremely strong-minded. We have the opportunity to accomplish our dreams, live our best lives, break barriers, and change the world. We are the future. You are the future. As we cross the stage tonight and go our separate ways, think about all the great times we have had as a class and all the important lessons we've learned. Then, go out into that great big world and set it on fire. In the words of Ralph Waldo Emerson, do not go where the path may lead, go instead where there is no path and leave a trail. 2018, go leave a trail. Thank you.
Never in the halls of a familiar place. never open-eyed, optimistic, and ready to take on the world with open arms. So right now, I want you to look around and reminisce the small moments. It's about time that we pack our lives in the boxes and hug everyone goodbye. Because before each of you leave, I think back on the last 4,680 days. Cherish those small moments and never forget them. Because before you know it, another 4,680 days will have come and gone. Find your broken crayon. What will you draw in the next 4,680 days?
I remember my mother taking me to pre-K, and they put me in Head Start because I was underage. My mother wanted me to go to pre-K so bad, we spent the whole day in the administration office. That's when I got this wonderful class. Just a side note, this is probably one of the smartest rooms I will ever be in. I look around this room, I look at the 19 sitting on the front row, I look at the people behind me, even the people in the audience. I have learned everything I know from the people in this room. I also can't leave out my father. I have to thank him for putting a basketball in my hands at the age of three. I spent a lot of hours on the sport. I have to thank our teachers and administration for the great influence they've had on each of us. Not only did they teach us academic material, but they offered us guidance for probably the most important time of our lives. I also want to thank all the parents in this class. Y'all deserve an award too. You guys have done the hard work. You, the parents, are the real reason why we're here tonight. Y'all have raised a good group of kids well, and last but not least, I have to thank my classmates. We are all sitting here tonight because of one another. We have challenged and encouraged each other to get where we are tonight. I will miss you guys, but you are forever be in my heart. As I take my seat, I would truly like to give thanks to everyone who has played a part in getting us to where we are tonight. This exciting, wonderful night. Thank you for myself and the entire Peabody Classic Station.
Good evening. I'm Jill Biff, and I'm very pleased and honored to be presenting the Peabody High School Academic Accolades for the class of 2018. We're going to begin with the Peabody Scholars. The Peabody Scholars is the highest award that can be given to our graduates. We recognize our Peabody Scholars in lieu of valedictorian and salutatorian. They are seated on the front row of the graduating class and are wearing scholars' medallions. I'm pleased to announce that we have a record high this year of students who qualified to be a Peabody Scholar, with 19. To be a Peabody Scholar, a formula is applied that combines their GPA with a combination of their ACT superscore, which means that if students have taken the ACT more than once, we choose their highest score in the subcategories. As I announce your names, please stand, Peabody Scholars, and remain standing until all names are called, at which time we will applaud. Peabody Scholars for Peabody High School, class of 2018, Jada Baker, Emmalyn Bridges, Morgan Campbell, Chloe Cates, Michael Crutchfield, Kaylee Franks, Zachary Grooms, Heather Heatherly, Michaela Jones, Amy Leitian, Jasmine Love, Daisy Martinez, Bethany McKenzie, Dixie Reed, Claire Rollins, Anna Tubbs, Logan Warren, and Brantley Whitwell. Let's give these students a big round of applause. Next, I would like to honor the State of Tennessee Honor Graduates. To get this achievement, these students have met all four ACT benchmarks, 18 in English, 22 in reading, 22 in math, and 23 in science. This means that these students have a 50% or better chance of scoring a B or higher when they get to colleges and universities in these subjects. Students, please stand when your name is called and remain standing. Cecilia Angel, Jada Baker, Emmalyn Bridges, Sterling Birch, Morgan Campbell, Chloe Cates, Michael Crutchfield, Rennie Irvin, Timothy Fields, Haley Franks, Zachary Greens, Heather Heatherly, Alexis Hickerson, Michaela Jones, Amy Leitian, Jasmine Love, Keely Malone, Daisy Martinez, Bethany McKenzie, Molly Milligan, Leah Pivas, Dixie Reed, Claire Rollins, Anna Tubbs, Isaiah Wade, Logan Warren, Bradley Whitwell, and Austin Workman. Let's give these kids a round of applause. Now we would like to recognize our graduates who are graduating with the award of summa cum laude. With this achievement, these students have earned a GPA of 3.76 to 4.0. These students are designated with purple cords. Students, please stand when your name is called and remain standing. Cecilia Angel, Jada Baker, Emmalyn Bridges, Morgan Campbell, Chloe Cates, Michael Crutchfield, Rennie Irvin, Kaylee Franks, Zachary Grooms, Heather Heatherly, Hunter Hudson, Michaela Jones, Amy Leitian, Jasmine Love, Matthew Martin, Daisy Martinez, Bethany McKenzie, Ishan Patel, Claire Rollins, Anna Tubbs, Logan Warren, Brantley Whitwell, Austin Workman. Let's give these graduates a round of applause. Now we would like to recognize the graduates who are graduating with the award of Magna Cum Laude. These students are graduating with a GPA of 3.51 to 3.75 and are designated with green cords. Graduates, please stand when your name is called and remain standing. Angela Abbott. Preston Black. Timothy Fields. Will Fisher. Megan Gordon. Alexis Hickerson. Keely Malone. Molly Milligan. Landon Picker. Leah Pybus. Dixie Reed. Martina Rosnowski. Caitlin Starr. Jacob Taylor, Shelby Temple, Isaiah Wade. Stephen Stewart, round of applause. You may be seated. Now to recognize the graduates who are graduating with the distinction of cum laude. These students have earned a GPA of 3.26 to 3.50 and are designated with blue cords. Sterling Birch. Mallory Shute. Caden Coleman. Jason Comer. Stephanie Goss. Brianna Howell. Kaylee Jones. Katie Picker. And Hayden Toll. Let's give the students a round of applause. Now to recognize our Peabody Honor graduates. These graduates earned the distinction by having a GPA of 3.0 to 3.25. They are designated by the ladies having black cords and the gentlemen having gold cords. Please stand when your name is called. Isaiah Guest. Joshua Jones. Kristen Lowry. Zoe McCall. Michael Scott. And Kaylee Stevens. Please give these graduates a round of applause. One last note. If you'll notice in your bulletin that some students have a parenthesis after their name. That indicates the number of college credit hours that student has completed while in high school. I would like to recognize two of these by standing when I call your name. Leah Pybus, who has earned 30 college credit hours while in high school. Bethany McKenzie, who has earned 33 college credit hours while in high school. These students will both begin college as a college sophomore.
Good evening. New at Peabody this year is the Work Ethic Certificate. This program is a consortium of West Tennessee high schools and local businesses and industries. The program was initiated by the workforce out of a need to find employees with good soft skills. This year, Peabody seniors can earn the Work Ethic Certificate by acquiring 20 points from a number of categories such as school attendance, number of tardies, discipline, grade point average, a negative drug screen, meeting Tennessee Promise deadlines, earning industry certifications, earning college credit, and applying to a post-secondary institution. This first year, we have 13 seniors who were awarded the Work Ethics Certificate on Tuesday night at the Honors Program. Please stand and be recognized when I call your name. Jada Baker, Chloe Cates, Stephanie Doss, Renee Irvin, Megan Gordon, Brianna Howell, Jasmine Love, Bethany McKenzie, Ishan Patel, Leah Pibas, Claire Rollins, Martina Rosnowski, and Caitlin Starr.
Scholarships, but this is an interesting take on it. This one applicant had written about the person that it was in memory of. They recognized the person it was in memory of, and I thought, that's pretty cool. You're taking the time out to see how this scholarship originated. Most of these scholarships, like the alumni, are in memory of somebody. You know, there are family members here that they're dedicated to. And I really appreciate that, and I appreciate the families that are here, the families that were honoring their loved one. And I appreciate the businesses that go out and establish these scholarships, and the churches that go out and establish these scholarships. They're invested in you. They care about our youth, and they care about your future. So before we recognize you, I would like to recognize them and show them that we appreciate them and how they care about you and your future. So can we recognize them for a moment? All right, now let's get to the fun stuff. Okay, the first one that we have wasn't on the insert, so we're going to start right now.
First of all, it is an honor to be here tonight to see all you students being recognized. I know it's been an exciting 4 years, and you're looking forward to getting through this, so we just pray the upcoming years will be even greater, you know, as you go into your higher education. My name is David Spencer, and I'm with Tobin Life Insurance Company. And we have what we call a Focus Forward Scholarship, and we present all over the nation. Our company gives nearly $1 million in scholarships. And so we've got one special person here tonight we want to present a scholarship to. And this person that's going to be receiving this, we know all of her life there, and so it's an honor to be able to present this to her tonight. We recognize her, and this is a $500 Women Focus Forward Scholarship to Hannah Tubbs. Also, while she remains standing, we also have another special recognition tonight that we're going to present. And this is very special. This is an endowment from her late grandmother, Miss Pauline Westbrooks, and she asked me to present this at Anna's graduation, so it's an honor to be able to do this tonight. And she also made an endowment for Anna to help her in her higher education, so she'll be receiving over $65,000 for that. So
$1,000 is going to Chloe Cates.
The Farmers and Merchants Bank for $400, Will Fisher.
The Trenton Exchange Club, this goes to a student who will be attending Dyersburg State, $500 to Dixie Reed.
County Farm Bureau, $750 each to Chloe Cates and Mallory Shute.
Eddie's Pharmacy, $500 each, Claire Rollins and Morgan Campbell.
International Brotherhood Electrical Workers, Robert G. Tate Scholarship, $3,500 per year, $14,000 total.
Good evening. The Dyersburg Alumni Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated is proud to present Michaela Jones our academic scholarship in the amount of $500.
Trenton Rotary Club for $750, Morgan Campbell.
Trenton Healthcare Foundation, $1,000, Heather Heatherly.
All right, this is the debate of the word. Trenton Elks Crappie Tournament Scholarship, $500 each, and then the Bob Patterson Scholarship, $100 each, goes to Hunter Hudson, Emmalyn Bridges, and Haley Toe. Please all stand.
E.C. Crafton, $200 each, Morgan Campbell, and Claire Rollins.
Good evening, and congratulations to the class of 2018. On behalf of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Theta Eta Omega Chapter, we would like to present a $1,000 scholarship to our recipient, our loved one, Michaela Jones.
This is a scholarship through Farm Credit Mid-America, $2,000 for Chloe Cates.
DFW Essay Contest, $200 each, Brandon Whitlow and Morgan Campbell.
All right, this is thanks to the Chamber of Commerce. There is a Gibson County Jumpstart Grant for $250 each. We have several students. If you'll all each stand when I call your name and remain standing until everyone is called out. Zach Brooms, Brianna Howe, Molly Milligan, Chloe Cates, Haley Toe, Matthew Martin, Morgan Campbell, Megan Gordon, Kaylee Jones, and Leah Pivas.
Hi, I'm Michael Allen. I'm the ag teacher here at Peabody High School, and I'm here to present the FFA Alumni Scholarship. The FFA Alumni is a group of parents and individuals who would like to help our local FFA chapter out. So if there's anyone out there that is a former member or a parent that, or an individual would just like to help, see me or Mr. Tony Moore at some time to find out some more information. This year, the FFA Alumni Scholarship and the FFA Leadership Scholarship in the amount of $500 each goes to Miss Bethany McKenzie.
Trenton Housing Authority, $1,500. Heather Heatherly.
First Presbyterian Church, $500 each. Emily Bridges and Haley Toll.
Eldad Baptist Church, $500. Molly Milligan.
Hi, my name is Larry Kaufman, the proud grandfather of John Kaufman. The John Kaufman Scholarship was established in his memory for a senior football player or football cheerleader. We had some very good applications this year. It was hard to pick, and we'd like to thank all that applied. The person selected for the John Kaufman $1,000 scholarship is Morgan Campbell.
Good evening. My name is Peggy Donaldson, and I'm here representing the McLean Power Systems Company in Trenton, Tennessee. Our company is a family-owned business that was established in 1925. Four generations later, we have two different divisions, our automotive side and our power side, which together generate over $1 billion a year in revenue. The McLean family strongly supports continuing education, community involvement, and an entrepreneurial spirit. As a result, each of the 14 plants in the U.S. give scholarships valued at over $12,000. The McLean Power Systems Trenton facility awards scholarships at Peabody High School, Milan High School, and South Gibson High School each year. These scholarship awards are not based solely on grades and ACT, but also extracurricular activities, student accomplishments, and the embodiment of the entrepreneurial spirit. Although it's not required either, emphasis in the STEM studies does give some preference. This process works by students submitting their high school transcripts, their ACT information, and writing a series of essays about themselves. The personal information is removed from each application, and a selection committee determines a set of finalists. Those finalists are then interviewed personally by the selection committee. This year's applicants formed a very competitive field, and each of the students and their parents really should be proud of their accomplishments. So tonight, I would like to announce that the McLean Power Systems Scholarship for Peabody High School goes to Ms. Kaylee Franks. Congratulations, Kaylee, for me after I know about you.
Following scholarships and all the money will be awarded to Michaela Jones, Vessels of Promise Award in memory of Lucille Jarrett, $650. New Springfield Church, $250. Trinity Baptist Association, $350. And P. Ridge Book Club, $500 for Michaela Jones.
Alumni Association gives out scholarships, and we have several there. All right, our first one for $500 is the Aldarius Buckway Junior Memorial Scholarship for $500. Landon Pickford.
Hello, I'm Terry Hickerson. My scholarship for Adam James Dickerson Memorial Scholarship. It's given to a four-year football player. This year it's going to be a little different in the fact that his daughter, Alexis Dickerson, will be graduating, and we're going to give her that scholarship this year. Thank you.
$500, Walter Kilzer Memorial Scholarship, Brandon Whipple.
A.F. Bridges Memorial Scholarship, Hunter Hudson.
Andy Stott Memorial Scholarship for $500, Chloe Cates and Claire Robbins.
Congratulations to the class, Peabody High School 2018. As I stand before you tonight, very emotional, I have something on behalf of my father, Mr. Darrell Dorsett, that I would like to read in the first annual scholarship in memory of my father. Standing here tonight is very emotional for me. I tragically lost my daddy, Mr. Darrell Dorsett, 6 months ago. My daddy was the greatest man I will ever know, and he was a wonderful friend to all who knew him. If you never met him, you certainly missed out. I would like to share for just a brief moment something with you. Due to his God-given talents and expertise knowledge in all things maintenance, he was recruited in 1955 from PHS Ag Mechanics class to work at Old Peabody High School as a sophomore on the school boiler, the heating, the cooling, and even climb that old water tower at the request of former Superintendent Lyle Putnam on numerous times to repair the very top of that water tower. Whom here tonight can say they could build a working transistor radio from a matchbox at the early age of 4 years old? My daddy did just this. He was a born genius, and he used his mind and hands to serve others. Daddy was that servant with a heart of gold. He helped me work for the Trenton Special School District and West Tennessee School Systems a combined career of 60 years. I feel confident that if heaven's gates are not revolving gates, when my daddy entered them, he has made that possible at this time. In closing, due to the amazing generosity of support from friends and family, we have established the annual Gerald Dorsett Memorial PHS Alumni Scholarship. I have prayed fervently that I would select a student who has worked faithfully, like my daddy, exceeded their goals, and also has that servant's heart of gold. So for the first time tonight, in loving memory of my father, Mr. Darrell Dorsett, I would like to present a 500 scholarship in his memory to Miss Leah Pipus.
Congratulations, Leah.
Peabody Alumni Association, we have 20 scholarships that total over $10,000. Next, we're going to move on to, we have one more $500 Peabody Alumni General Scholarship Fund for Ms. Kelly Franks. Making that a total of over $10,500. Talk about institutional scholarships. I know we have a lot more to cover, but we'll go as fast as we can. First, we have a scholarship from the University of Tennessee at Knoxville. our very own Miss Jasmine Love. Miss Jasmine Love is getting the Tennessee Pledge Scholarship, which is worth $12,790 per year, which is a total of $51,160.
People are receiving scholarships from UT Martin. Chloe Cates is receiving University Scholars, $5,000 per year for $20,000 total. Excellent scholarship, $1,000 per year, $4,000 total. And the Harold Connor Award, $2,000 per year for $8,000 total, Matthew Martin. Chancellor Award, $3,000 per year, $12,000 total, Zach Brooks. Also receiving Chancellor Award, $3,000 per year, $12,000 total, Anna Tubbs. Receiving the Dean Scholarship, $2,000 per year, $8,000 total, Austin Worthen. Advanced scholarship for $750 per year, $3,000 total, Will Fisher.
All right, next we have UT Chattanooga, Claire Rollins. She will be receiving the Chancellor Scholarship, $5,000 per year, for a total of $20,000. I also have Jada Baker from UT Chat getting the Provost Scholarship, $4,000 a year for a total of
$16,000. From MTSU, MTSU Trustee Scholarship, $5,000 per year, $20,000 total, Logan Boyd. The True Blue Scholarship, $3,000 per year, $12,000 total, Jacob Taylor.
University of Memphis, Heather Heatherly, Dean Scholarship, $3,000 per year for a total of $12,000.
For Martin Methodist, the Martin Scholarship, $22,746 per year, for a total of $90,984, Brantley Wilkins. Athletic scholarship, we'll go ahead and say football, $100,000, Hutchinson Community College, Chance Hill.
Austin Peay State University, Isaiah Wade for the Dean Scholarship, $2,000 per year for a total of $8,000.
Bethel University Athletic Scholarship, Girls Basketball, $10,300 per year for a total of $41,200 for 4 years, Stacy Mayberry.
The Colbert Future Leader, $1,000 per year, Freshman Academic Excellence, $1,500. Peggy Davis Shipman Endowment, $450. Quentin and Maude Stringer Endowment, non-resident scholarship equivalent. She has an equivalent person via Veterans Waiver. Her dad was a veteran, which has a value of up to $14,000 per year. So if you add everything up for Bethany, she's getting approximately $69,000 for her 4 years. And then we have Ms. Kelly Grant, who's also attending the Mississippi State. State University, and she also has this many Culver Future Leader Scholarship Award, $2,000 a year, Freshman Academic Excellence Scholarship, $4,500 per year, Non-Resident Scholarship, $9,500 per year, Student Body President, $1,500 per year, Cynthia N. Stevens Loyalty Scholarship, $1,000 per year, and I think she still has some pending scholarships, but right now we're around the $75,000 to $80,000 mark.
Jackson State Community College Athletic Scholarship, boys basketball, $9,000 per year, $18,000 for 2 years. Cam Luke.
All right, the last couple of things we want to do, as you may know, in Tennessee, we have the Hope Eligible Scholarship, and that means you have a GPA of 3.0 or a 21 on the ACT. These students will receive up to $3,500 their first year and their second year, and if they maintain that GPA or that ACT, it goes up to $4,500 their third and their fourth year. So all of our students who are HOPE eligible, I ask that you stand at this time. And let's recognize them. Okay, on top of the HOPE, we have 7 students who have exceeded the 3.75 mark with a 21 ACT. This is going to qualify them for additional $1,500 per year. The following students, please stand up. This is called the General Assembly Merit Scholarship. Chloe Cates, Michael Crutchfield, Kaylee Franks, Amy Letienne, Claire Rollins, Anna Tubbs, and Logan Moore. So these are our General Assembly Merit Scholarships. Next we have Tennessee Promise. All of our HOPE scholarship people are qualified if they choose to go to a 2-year school, so they're qualified. But for Tennessee Promise, you must attend a meeting, you must do your financial aid paperwork, and you must do 8 hours of community service. But these folks are committed to going to a 2-year school, a community college, or a technical school. So can I get all my kids who are going to a 2-year school or a technical school to please stand up? They can go tuition free. Alright, last category I want to recognize before we close it out is our military. We have several students going into military, and they are going to get enlistment bonuses. All right, so for the Army, I need Josh Jones to stand up. He's getting a silent bonus, $10,500. Amy Coleman, Army, $3,000. For the Navy, I have Quinn Jumper, $15,000. The things you're going to do from here forward. And I think Coach Jacobs is going to close us out and give you our grand total, our estimated total for the next 4 years, which is amazing. And we appreciate everything our community does. We appreciate everything you guys do.
Total scholarship money presented at Peabody's graduations always exceed $1 million. The total amount this year for the next 4 years is $1,672,594. Please recognize and thank Mr. Eddie Bragg and the Peabody faculty and staff for their efforts in making this possible. Special mention goes to Ms. Gallup, the senior sponsors, Michael Allen, Ella Brown, Debbie Grant, Aldra Hines, Frank Hodges, Andre Joyner, Angelisa Boyd, Heather Webb, and Stephen Westwood. I'd like to introduce and thank for your support Director Tim Haney, the Central Office staff, the Trenton Special School District board members, Chairman Dr. Mark Harper, Ms. Deanne McNew, Mr. Clint Hickerson, Mr. Doug Smith, and Mr. Justin Lee. Please join me in recognizing the efforts of this faculty, Director Tim Haney, and the school board.
Thank you.
Claire Bridge Rodden. Anna Claire Tubbs. Logan Grant Warren. Brantley David Whipple. Angela Christine Abbott. Sean Deontay Ball. Cecilia Angel. Sean Deontay Ball. Horacio Alejandro Barrientos Valacuna. Kristen Lynn Bell. Preston Keith Blackbird. Kanetta Edwin Blake. Sterling Marcellus Birch. Richard Kenton Irving.
Timothy Dwayne Fields II. William Austin Fisher. Diamond Nicole Yanaway. Isaiah Jason Guest. Julie Jordan Haynes. Madison Nicole Heathcock. Nicole Nickerson. Gregory Mitchell Peel. Chance Dante Peel. Hunter Chase. Zatavius Dewan Hunt. Ricky Deontay. Jacob Hurdle. Leah Brienne Hyatt.
Everybody now and ever, we will
graduating class of 2018.